Thank you. this coverage wherever you are this morning, as we bring to you live coverage of the line and state of the late Calder Benjamin Williams, former Member of Parliament, former Leader of the Opposition. What you're seeing on your screens, a live video feed of Parliament in Kingstown, where the final mortal remains of Mr. Williams arrived just about 4 minutes ago. And as we hear just on the outside of where we're broadcasting from, the remains being moved to the Assembly Chamber, which has been configured for this occasion. There are 6 pallbearers of the Royal St. Vincent and the Grenadines Police Force, all dressed in their white tunics, and they're all sergeants, and taking the remains into the Parliament Chamber, this time draped in the flag of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, just behind the remains of Mr. Williams. We see the arrival of the family of the late Mr. Williams, who will be seated in Parliament as well to exchange greetings with those who pay their final respects today. Of course, there'll be a period for official viewing. That's by the members of Parliament, current members of Parliament, and there'll also be a period designated for the public. So from 11 to noon, the members of the public will have the opportunity to view the final remains of Mr. Williams. For those who may not be familiar with Mr. Calder Williams, he served in the Parliament of St. Vincent and the Grenadines during the 1970s, and particularly from 1979 until 1984, and two of those years he served as the leader of the then opposition, New Democratic Party. So there was a period where he served as leader of the opposition during his time. He was also the founder and the president of the now defunct New Rescuers Movement, or NRM. That's a group established in the 1970s, which catered specifically for those who were suffering from rural underdevelopment. And this was his most remembered contribution, particularly during the time when he founded and was the president of the NRM. Outside of that, he was known to be a very humble man. From all the information that we have, he was known to be very a quiet individual, a reserved individual, despite being actively involved in politics during the time that he spent in service to the people. He made quite a lot of friends along the way, and following his passing, there were some remarks that were shared about him, particularly by those who worked along with him in the 80s on social media and in the various other platforms. So we do know that he certainly left his mark. As we see now, the body will be displayed in the center of the chamber, as is customary on this occasion, and an area demarcated for those who will come to view the final mortal remains. We see the preparations being made for the opening of the coffin, and momentarily we should see that taking place, and the undertakers will do their necessary preparations in order to ready the body for viewing. It's a very cloudy morning here in capital city Kingstown. Some drizzles, light showers in between. A very bleaky looking morning, as we would generally say. And certainly a solemn mood for this occasion. The very light day traffic wise, at least at this time in Kingstown, not a lot of traffic as is usually the case on mornings or late afternoons. And those who will come by today to pay their respects to the late Member of Parliament, I expect to do so rather shortly. First, the officials will come. I see in the distance, as I look through the windows of Parliament, the Honourable Prime Minister, who appears to be arriving at this point in time. So we prepare for that, and shortly we'll be joined by radio as well. In a minute from now, we will also have the body being fully ready for viewing. And again, if you are just joining us, we welcome you across the various platforms and social media. We're live across the pages of the Agency for Public Information, VC3 Television, and the National Broadcasting Corporation. On this occasion, the official viewing of the mortal remains for the late former Member of Parliament for North Leeward, the area which he represented during his time in this Parliament. Calder Benjamin Williams also served as the opposition leader while he was MP for North Leeward. So, as we await the Prime Minister to come into the chamber, and shortly we will, of course, see him entering this area. So we will stay with you as we bring you what is happening here on location at the Parliament building. As we continue to bring coverage of the permanent state of the body of the late Mr. Calder Benjamin Williams, those who are viewing, we let you know that the Honourable Prime Minister has arrived at the chamber here at Parliament and has just affixed his notes to the Book of Condolences. So too has Her Excellency Dame Susan Duggan. And now Her Excellency will be officially the first official to view the remains of Mr. Williams. And she does so and makes her way across to the area for the family. Quite a number of members of the family gathered here this morning for this occasion. And as we have the Honourable Prime Minister, who is now making his way to the mortal remains of Mr. Collins, prepares to pay his final respects. As a matter of fact, does so now, paying his final respects to Mr. Williams, moves across to where the family is gathered for a brief word with those who are here gathered, and shares some, you know, condolences and with members of the immediate family of Mr. Williams. Of course, Mr. Williams passed away on March 29th. and he was 68 at the time of his passing. A few years of his life serving in this very at this morning, as he today is in state. He will be laid to rest tomorrow, tomorrow being the official. As we welcome those who are viewing on all the various platforms, those who are listening by radio, as radio joins us, we welcome you to the state of Speaker of Assembly. She is in the process of paying her last. So to the Clerk of the House, as we now again joined by the those on radio, in addition to our those joining by way of the various platforms. We're live on NBC Radio, VC3 Television, the Agency for Public Information, and the National Broadcasting Corporation, both on social media and on radio. For those who joined us on radio, the body of Mr. Williams arrived here at Parliament this morning at exactly 10 minutes to 10, and was brought upstairs and is now lying in state to the center of the chamber. Of course, the usual accordances of that of our official funeral, and the first part of the viewing is that designated for officials. A few minutes ago, the Honourable Prime Minister paid his final respects, and so too did the Governor General, Her Excellency Dame Susan Duggan, paid her final respects as well at this time. And at this time, rather, we're having just a bit of a brief. We expect today to see current members of Parliament, former members of Parliament, particularly those who served along with him, coming by for this occasion. And for those who may just be joining us and you're wondering, maybe you've never heard about this individual, and he served this country in this very Parliament that he's lying in state in 1979, actually from 1979 through to 1984, and during that time he was also a leader of the opposition for 2 years while serving as Member of Parliament for North Leeward. He was known to many as a simple man, and from the feedback we've been given about the man we're laying to rest tomorrow, he lived by a simple rule, and it was service to the people. So for him, it wasn't about fame or popularity. For those that we spoke to in preparation for this coverage today, he was known to be a humble man, a man of service, and no doubt today he is being accorded what is due to him as one who rendered human service to the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines as a member of this Honourable Parliament. We are now seeing that members of the immediate family have been permitted to view the remains of Mr. Williams. There's a very large gathering this morning of family members and those who are closely related to him. Of course, there's a seating arrangement for the immediate family, and the chairs are filled up, as a matter of fact. So there's a bit of a line that has formed as the remains of Mr. Williams. As mentioned, it's a very cloudy morning, some showers, sprinkles in between, and a few downpours in between. St. Vincent and the Grenadines today. A very solemn sort of mood as you enter the Parliament building, and generally in Kingstown today. It's not one of the usual hustle and bustle days, at least not outside. The traffic is relatively slow on the outside, and not the usual hustle and bustle as it gets closer to the end of the month. But a very big representation this morning from his family, who are here to pay their final respects on this, the viewing of the final mortal remains of Mr. Calder Williams. We'll of course bring you coverage here on NBC Radio. And we'll leave you in a few minutes from now, segue into the Prime Minister's press conference, and continue with our visual coverage across our social media platforms. I'll be here with you to during that time to let you know what's happening, so you can continue viewing when we leave on the radio end in a few minutes from now. Just to indicate as well that Calder Williams was a single daughter. He had, of course, the he had siblings, sisters Kezita, Volita, and Venita, and one brother. Those relatives, and we do know from what we've read about Benjamin, he passed away he left his mark in service to St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I apologize for the drops we're experiencing there in our audio. Can tell you the mood is one of a solemn one, and of course the this morning we will have members of Parliament coming through the chambers to pay their final respects. We just had moments ago, as mentioned, ourselves a bit of a break in our audio there. I apologize for that, just as we reposition our microphones to give you a better vantage point, as we do have visuals in the chamber. The members of the family had the opportunity moments ago to view the remains of Mr. Williams, and as I speak to you now, I suspect their vehicles pulling into the yard, and we expect momentarily we'll have the arrival of other officials, other dignitaries, who will view the final mortal remains of Mr. Williams today. We mentioned it's a very solemn moment, and case you don't know who Mr. Calder Williams is, Calder Benjamin Williams, he's from Chateaubelay, and that is the community and the constituency. He served North Leeward, which Chateaubelay is part of, several years in Parliament, and he was a man of the community. Those who are from North Leeward area will be familiar, I'm sure, with Mr. Williams, having heard about his time and the time he provided service to the country. As mentioned earlier, before we had a bit of an interruption of the audio feed, he was survived by an only daughter, Shelley McIntosh, and sisters Kezita, Volita, and Venita, and also one brother, Isaiah, a very closely knit family. And today is one of 2 days where he'll be remembered for his time of service, and tomorrow being the funeral service and the burial at Chateaubelay. Of course, we'll journey to Chateaubelay tomorrow to bring that to you live across the various platforms, so we hope that you'll be able to join us tomorrow via the platforms on television, social media, and radio, as we provide coverage of the official funeral service of former Member of Parliament and Leader of the Opposition, Mr. Calder Benjamin Williams. Calder Williams was born in 1953, in April, to be specific, 1953, and he passed away in March of 2022. And he was known to be a simple man. As a matter of fact, his mantra was service to the people. And in the reflection shared by those who knew him, they would tell you that he was a man who meant what he said in terms of being humble about his service to the people. And from the reflections I've read on social media, the postings about him and the stories, having served as MP, he made a lot of contacts along the way. When he served in the Parliament in North Leeward, he's actually the first elected Member of Parliament for the Democratic Party on mainland St. Vincent. So that's something you may not have known about him. He has that unique distinction of being the first New Democratic Party candidate to be elected to serve the St. Vincent, mainland St. Vincent. And as we have visuals of the body lying in state at the assembly, it appears there'll be a change in the guard shortly as the process is being executed in true fashion. Bit of a handover between the police officer and the cadet officer at this time, as the changing of the guard occurs, and the guard faces south. And we also observe the protocols being adhered to here in the chamber, where once you come into the chamber, you're required to wear your mask, and for the public who will be coming to view the final mortal remains of Mr. Williams, we do remind you that it is a requirement that you, of course, be dressed appropriately for the chamber. In addition to that, there'll be no photographing of the body once you get into the chamber. You would expect to be expected to wear a mask as well as you enter the chamber. They're all in place for the safety of everyone on this occasion. For those who are listening by way of radio, as mentioned earlier, we'll leave you on the radio end in a few minutes once the press conference is ready at Cabinet Room. But in the interim, we await the other officials to file past the body of Mr. Williams. He ran on the NDP ticket in 1979, and that general election year, which is also the year that we became an independent nation. And incidentally, the eruption of Lhasa Phraya also took place in that year. So 1979 was a very eventful occasion, and one that had a number of markers for Mr. Williams. It also signaled his start of that journey in service to the people. It spanned for 5 years in total, having been in office until 1984. I see the Honorable Frederick Stevenson is now signing the book of condolences just outside our broadcast point here, and he will proceed to pay his respects to Mr. Williams and then leave the chamber. Earlier on, we saw the Honorable Prime Minister, who was accompanied by Her Excellency. They're actually very close to each other. The Her Excellency Dame Susan Duggan was the first to view this morning, immediately followed by the Honorable Prime Minister. And now we have the Honorable Frederick Stevenson, Member of Parliament, current Member of Parliament, and representative for South Wynwood, as he takes the opportunity to exchange greetings with those who are here from the family this morning. I suspect condolences. And as he does so, he leaves the Parliament chamber, as is customary. The Honorable Dr. Orlando Brewster just signed a book of condolences, and he too at this time is paying his final respects and gives a bow to the family as he exits the Parliament chamber. I suspect shortly we'll also see former parliamentarians as well in the mix, as the time allotted now is for officials, that is, current members of Parliament serving at this time, and also those from the diplomatic corps are expected to come at this point. Later on, it'll be open to the public, and those who are listening to us and those who are viewing would have an opportunity to pay respects to Mr. Williams from about 11 o'clock this morning until noon. The funeral service will not be held today. It will be held tomorrow, with a brief period of viewing and tributes from 11 to 12 o'clock tomorrow, and then from 12 noon the funeral service, followed by the burial in his home community of Chateaubelair. The service will take place at the New Testament Church of God in Chateaubelair, and the burial will be nearby at the Fitzhughes Cemetery. So, for those who wish to attend the funeral tomorrow, just to give you that bit of information, as we get ready to segue from what is happening here at the Assembly Chamber and prepare on radio, that is, for the next event which we have lined up in queue this morning, which is the press conference by the Honorable Prime Minister. We do encourage you to stay with us on this platform. Of course, we will continue to bring you coverage of the official viewing during the course of the hour, and we encourage you to stay with us as we pay our respects to the man who provided this service to St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Outside of being a politician, Mr. Williams was also a police officer, and we see a representation here from the Royal St. Vincent and the Grenadines Police Force, as it is customary for a funeral of this type. Besides being a police officer, he was a national cricketer, a trade unionist, a political activist, and a farmer. He spent a considerable amount of his life in farming, being from a community dominated by that profession. He spent a lot of his time tilling the soil and farming. And that's outside of his political life or his public life. He was a teacher in 1975, and incidentally, during the famous teacher strike in 1975, he was dismissed as a result of being a part of that. The famous teacher strike of 1975. That time he was actively engaged as a political activist, and as a result he lost his teaching position and then ventured into other areas of life, eventually coming into service as a politician 4 years later, sitting in this very parliament, the hollow chambers of the parliament of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And he was also the founder and the president of the now defunct NRM, the New Rescuers Movement. The NRM, of course, was a group that was established in the 70s, especially the mid-70s, around 1974-75. And the main purpose of this group was to rescue the people from rural underdevelopment, as he was a rural man by heart, and he knew the issues that his people faced, particularly as members of the various rural communities. And his call to action was to serve not just the people of Châteaubelay and surrounding areas, but the entire North Leeward constituency, which he did so in Parliament for several years, from 1979 to 1984. I mentioned it earlier, but many may have missed it. He was the first member of the New Democratic Party to represent on the mainland as the first person to hold a seat on the mainland for the New Democratic Party, the NDP, back in 1979. I see now a former colleague who, from the New Democratic Party, who shared that chamber with him, also affixing a signature to the Book of Condolences. And no doubt we'll see a number of former parliamentarians being present here this morning and paying their final respects to Mr. Williams, Calder Benjamin Williams, born April 14th, 1953. He passed away on the 29th of March, 2022. Today and tomorrow, the 2 days allotted to him as a mark of respect for his service to the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. See, former Member of Parliament, Harvey Young, is signing the Book of Condolences at this time, and continuing from where the others left off, in leaving some notes of comfort for the family. And as we're also following comments on the live streams. Yes, he was also a teacher. And I see someone mention it in the comment section. He was a teacher and was dismissed in 1975 when that famous strike took place. And just a note as well that we will be leaving on the radio end in just a few minutes. But before then, we will continue with our coverage, the visuals and also the audio. This is live coverage of the Lion in State of Mr. Calder Benjamin Williams, former Member of Parliament, leader of the opposition for 2 years, served between 1979 and 1984. Mr. Herbie Young is in the process of exchanging greetings with the family, paying his condolences, or paying his respects rather, I should say, and exchanging greetings with the members of the family who are gathered, and no doubt we'll see some of the individuals who served alongside him in this parliament this morning, and I'm sure during the funeral service tomorrow, a number of them who not just served alongside him but were inspired by his work and eventually entered the realms of politics because of his guidance. I'm sure we'll have some of those as well present between today and tomorrow. And we do note as well that tomorrow there wouldn't be an extensive viewing period as we're having today, but we're having from 10 o'clock until noon for the purpose of viewing. Tomorrow it'll just be 1 hour between 11 o'clock and noon, where there'll be some tributes as well, and the funeral service gets underway from 12 noon in Chateaubelair. The burial will follow immediately, and tomorrow all flags across St. Vincent and the Grenadines will fly at half-mast as a mark of respect. And for those who may not be aware of that, it's an opportune time that you take note of that as well. So all flags across St. Vincent and the Grenadines are expected to be flying at half-mast in remembrance of the late Calder Benjamin Williams, April 14th, 1953 to March 29th, 2022. He died at the age of 68. I mentioned earlier that he was also very much involved in farming, as he was a farmer outside of being a politician, and those in the community of Chateaubelair where he resided can testify to his involvement in farming. As a political activist as well, he was instrumental in the 1975 teacher strike. As a result of his involvement in that strike, he lost his teaching position, and he used that as a stepping stone to do greater things, eventually in service to his country at the highest level as a member of the esteemed Parliament of St. Vincent and the Grenadines and a representative for the constituency of North Leeward, an area he was no stranger to, having been born in Chateaubelair and from Chateaubelair. He was quite familiar with the needs of the people and what was required as service to the people, and from all indications he served as a humble man in this position by the simple rule that he should live and live in service to the people. From the information we've gathered about Mr. Williams, he came in at the age of 26, as a matter of fact, and he became the North Leeward candidate at the age of 26, later being elected as a member of Parliament. As we prepare to wrap up the radio end of our coverage, but we'll of course continue with the visual, so if you can, you can stay with us on the visual end. Of course, we hope that you'll be able to join us on tomorrow, that is tomorrow Friday, and we will bring you the coverage of the funeral service. Not quite ready as yet for the Prime Minister's press conference. As soon as they're ready for us, we'll wrap up on the radio end and get ready for that event. We are still at Parliament. Now we have the Honourable Leader of the Opposition, Dr. Godwin Friday. He's signing the Book of Condolences at this time. The current Leader of the Opposition, New Democratic Party, followed by Major Sinclair Leacock, who is closely in queue, and other members of the New Democratic Party, current members of Parliament. As we end off the radio coverage, we thank those who joined us as we prepare for the next item on our program on radio. We stand by for the live event. I see the Honorable Daniel Cummings and Patel Matthews, Roland Matthews, also here as well. I'm very close to him personally. And we leave you on radio at this time and head back to Master Control for further programming as we continue with the video feed for those who are staying with us online. for several years, that is. And in that time, he also had the distinct honor of representing the people. And as we look at the visuals of what's happening now, Mr. Anand Cruikshank, it appears, who served as a member of the parliament as well under the New Democratic Party, is now in the process of paying his final respects. He'll join those just outside the exit of the chamber by my other colleagues. I see now Mr. Cruikshank is moving to the area designated for family members, and in the distance I'm seeing a few others queued up to pay their respects. I suspect that in between the officials are members of his family or very dear friends or close friends to him that were also permitted to view during this time. See the representative from the New Democratic Party, I believe it's Fitzgerald Bramble, who is now signing the book of condolences. The Honourable Fitzgerald Bramble is paying his respects. He is a current member of the Parliament, or representing the New Democratic Party, and he is in the process of paying respects to Mr. Calder Williams, whose mortal remains lie in state at the Parliament building in Kingstown here this morning. Just on the outside are other media colleagues gathering their interviews with other members of Parliament, and we see happening inside Parliament now the exchange of greetings with members of the family. We are live across the various platforms on social media, across the pages of VC3 API and the National Broadcasting Corporation. This hour, of course, being allotted to members of the family as a bit of a lull in the procession of those who are paying respects. It's a bit of a break, I suspect. Shortly we'll see a few members of the diplomatic corps. We haven't observed any of those members of the diplomatic corps just yet. Just on the outside of the chamber, the leader of the opposition and other current members of parliament are having a bit of an exchange in terms of a conversation. And just outside where we're broadcasting from to some interviews are taking place for other platforms, other media colleagues. But certainly a day for the family of Mr. Williams, as he is being remembered for his service to the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The opportunity being shared by those who were close to him to view the remains of Mr. Williams, and of course share greetings with the family. Momentarily we will see other members, well, we expect other members of the Parliament, current, former parliamentarians, to join those already here and file past the mortal remains. Looking through the window of Parliament here, from where we're broadcasting from, the former offices of the Assembly, very rare opportunity to see down into the courtyard from the offices, see the flag flying at half mast, signifying the occasion. And tomorrow we'll have that in full effect, where all national flags of St. Vincent and the Grenadines will be flown at half mast, as a mark of respect on the passing of Mr. Williams and the funeral and the burial of Mr. Williams. Tomorrow, the funeral service will be held in Chateaubelay, and that will be immediately followed by the burial of the mortal remains of Mr. Williams. And there we see now on your screens a visual of the solitary flag of St. Vincent and the Grenadines at half mast, waving gently in the morning breeze on a very cloudy, or overcast, I should say, morning. No doubt the mood on the outside is quite similar to that of on the inside. And it's a remembrance of a man who was known to be a very simple man by nature, a farmer who dedicated most of his life to farming. He was a farmer by profession from the notes I was able to gather, and being elected to serve in the parliament at the age of 26. So he's a very young man when he was elected to parliament to serve. We're moments away from wrapping up our coverage on our social media platforms. In about 2 minutes we will close things off from our location here. Of course, we will continue to provide with coverage tomorrow. Tomorrow being the funeral service and the burial of Mr. Williams. We get ready to close off our coverage with some visuals as we have a lull in the filing past outside in the chamber, just outside our broadcast point, and a change of guards occurred just a few seconds ago. The body will be here at Parliament for another hour or so, just over an hour, where members of the public will be permitted to view. As we close off, just a few reminders for you. If you're coming to Parliament to view the remains of Mr. Williams, you're reminded that you are to dress appropriately for entry into the Parliament. No sleeveless, and of course, no short pants or jeans. And we ask that you respect the rules of the Parliament in terms of the dress code on this occasion, and also the mask policy, that you wear your mask as you come onto the compound of the Parliament building, and as you proceed upstairs to view the body and greet the family, you would be reminded to put on your mask if you do not do that as you come up the stairs. So be reminded of that. Sanitize, remember to sanitize as well, and of course, where possible, maintain your distance in the process as we continue to comply with the COVID-19 measures in place. So to wrap up this broadcast, has been a pleasure sharing with you this past hour or so, briefly on radio and also across all the platforms on social media, as we remember Calder Benjamin Williams, April 14th, 1953 to March 29th, 2022, Member of Parliament, 1979 to 1984, and former Leader of the Opposition for 2 years during that time. And we say so long from this broadcast as we lead out with some of the visuals here at the Parliament Chamber. And we invite you to join us across the platforms, radio, television, and social media tomorrow from just about noon for coverage of the funeral service from the Chateaubelay New Testament Church. On behalf of the production team here, and on behalf of the entire team comprising those at the National Broadcasting Corporation, the Agency for Public Information, and VC3 Television, we say thank you for joining us today and invite you to join us tomorrow. My name is Colvin Harry, and this is where I say so long as we lead out with some visuals from Parliament.